Hello guys, welcome back to GK Code Labs. If you are following my Apache Spark series, we are currently discussing the Spark structured streaming. So next topic in structured streaming I would like to discuss is output syncs. So out of the box, Apache Spark structured streaming provides us a variety of output syncs. First of all, let us discuss what is output sync. So a sync in case of a streaming scenario is the output container where all the streaming data after taking input and processing it, where do you want that streaming data to be kept as an output? That is a sync. So few of the syncs that structured streaming provides us are file sync. So let us discuss about file sync. Consider you are getting an input stream and whatever operations you are doing, creating multiple data frames in between. And finally, if you are writing that output into a file, the streaming output, that is considered as a file sync. So the same way, as I told, we use the write stream function to get the output of a streaming data. So with the same write stream function, let me zoom it a bit. So with the same write stream function, you can do whatever format you want the file to be, Parquet. It also supports JSON, CSV, as they have mentioned here. And in the option, you can give the path to the file, and same, you can start the streaming. So whatever the data that will be read into streams, that will be finally written into, once you call the write stream, that will be finally written into the file that you have defined. Next comes is Kafka sync. So as you know, Kafka is a very popular messaging queue that is used in big data. So if your project has Kafka already and you want to pair it with Spark streaming, so you have one Kafka sync option as well, in which you can define the format as Kafka. And the basic necessary requirements for the Kafka, that are bootstrap servers, that are the servers your consumers are running. So for the same, you can mention the host and the ports. And in the same option, you can give the topic you want to write that output to. So if you are aware of Kafka, if not, you can ignore it. But if you want to pair it with Kafka, you should have some idea about Kafka producers, consumers, the topics, what are they and how they will expect the streaming output. Same way, we have to pair it with Spark streaming, and we can take the output to the Kafka sync. Then comes the for each sync. For each sync is a bit interesting. Suppose if there are streams coming in and you want to do some operation on each and every input of the stream that is coming in, and you want to do that, you don't want to create intermediate data frames or intermediate RDDs. As soon as the streams come in, you want to do some small operation on each of the stream that is coming. So in that case, you can use the for each sync. So here they have not given much example, so let me tell you how that works. Let me open one. This is the previous code that I have shown in my previous video. If you have not seen that video, please find that in I button. So in just a small idea, we are just streaming the data in all the folders in the log files, and this is the kind of output that we are getting here. In my last video, I have built all this from the scratch. If you are interested, please see that. So currently, this is my streaming output that is coming from all the files in the logs directory. And here I am using the console sync. So all the output that currently is being dumped to the console. So that is a console sync. That is also one of the sync. We'll come to that later. So let us discuss about for each and how this works and where you should use it. So here you are saying, I'm not doing anything, whatever output is there, I'm just doing select star from SDF, whatever view I have created. Let's suppose for each of the input, I'm getting the date and the message here. Let's suppose I just want the messages, and let me first take just the messages so that, because it's not coming completely. So these are my message. Let's suppose for each of the message, I want to, let's say, append something. So for each like starting talent, I want to append something as soon as the stream, these lines in the streams come into the stream. So in such cases, rather than writing entire thing to console, we can make a function. And with the write stream only, we can do a for each on the input stream. Let me show how that works. Let's suppose, let's create a function first for appending any particular string to input string. So let's say val writer. This will be my function. And this is a special type of function if you are using it with for each sync. This for each sync, if you are using, you have to use for each writer library. So this is very important. Also a point to note that if you want to write a custom writer into the Spark streaming, whatever input is coming, you want to make a custom function. That whatever input is coming, I want to make a custom function to do something on that data. So for that, you can make a custom function by using the for each writer library. So for each writer, if I import, I'll take a new for each writer. So here you can see with this, we have imported the for each writer library of the Spark SQL. Now here we have to see what input we are getting. Suppose any input stream is coming, we are considering that as a row. So for particular row, for each row, we are applying this particular function. So this will expect input as a row. So let me import this as well, Spark SQL row. And now let's define this function. What we want, suppose for each and every row, we want to, as I told, we want to append something. So we have got the input as row. So for implementing this for each writer, you have to keep in mind, you have to implement three basic functions. These three functions are necessary to be implemented if you are writing a for each writer function. So those functions are open, process, and close. So if you are not sure and you are using IntelliJ, you can automatically get the definitions if you want. You can click here, and whatever unimplemented methods are there for, this is not for this particular function only, for whatever objects of a class that are that need to have some particular predefined functions. So for that, IntelliJ gives an option to implement whatever methods it is expecting. So let's do that. You can see here it is giving option for open, process, and close. Let's click on OK. So errors are gone. So for open function, this will have to return a boolean, and we have to create a connection. Let's just give a true. And now for process functions, what we have to process now? So whatever we are getting input row, you can see same thing. This process function is expecting as a value. So this particular value variable, this will have the actual string or input one row that is coming, the value of that row. So what we have to do, we can println, and what we have to print, value. And if in case you have, as of now we have only one column, in case you have multiple columns, so you can define it by, so because if there are multiple columns, they will be available at the index of that particular row. So let's say value dot get, you can mention 0, and onto this, after that we can do a, let's append something like underscore gk. So this will return the value plus underscore gk, and as we are doing this in for each writer function, this will be implemented for each and every row that is coming. We'll see that. And for close, we don't have any definition, so let's close it. So now in place of write stream, we don't want to print it on console. First of all, what we can do, we can do for each, and in this for each we can pass the writer function, that is our writer, that is the function we define. So what will happen, it will write stream for each writer, the writer function will be used, and then the output mode is there, and rest will be same. Let's try to execute this. You can see here, right, for each and every string we are getting an appended string, whatever we wanted, using the for each. So this was basically the for each sync. Hope you get it. Next is console sync. I already told you, in past all my tutorials I have been using console sync, where we were printing each and everything on the console. So So that is for the debugging purpose, in case you are running and you want to see what output is coming. So in those cases you can use the console sync. Next is memory sync. Same way as we are printing into a file or console, the same way as the console sync was being used, every output was there on the console. In memory sync, each and every output will be on the memory. There will be a temporary memory table, and this is also used for debugging only. If you want to see what amount of data is fit for having it in memory, or you want to do some testing, in that cases you can save this in memory. So this is the normal format memory you have to mention, and the query name, that is a temporary table that will be created in memory in which all your data will be stored. Make sure you don't use the memory sync in case of large data, because it will occupy all your memory. So thank you guys for watching this video. Hope the output sync of structured streaming were clear to you. Please hit that like button if you really like this video, and please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. Thank you guys. See you in my next video.